I would like to introduce today's presenter, Mr. Vishal Shah, CEO and co-founder of Synersoft Technologies. He is known as Season Technologies Short, an inventor of specific patented technologies, a writer, a serial entrepreneur, an investor, and most importantly, a go-to guide to MSMEs. We will have a question and answer session at the end of our meeting. Vishal sir, over to you, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Prasanna, for a generous introduction. And we are happy that we are able to start the webinar on time. And I see so many participants already joined. And, you know, I hope a few more would be joining, you know, as they remember it well. And, you know, they're going to join. So we are starting our agenda today. And as we all know that we have set the topic as work from home. So we know the relevance of the topic, and there is no other time, you know, more appropriate than this to have this kind of topic for the webinar. So Synersoft has started this kind of webinar series, you know, for the first time. And I'm privileged to start that particular series with the first topic. And I think that this topic is very, very relevant in this current time, in this COVID times, I would say. So we have made a short presentation. I'm going to share the flow of this particular session. Basically, this webinar is on work from home, risk, challenges, and solutions. So we will first understand the modalities of work from home when you want to provide work from home or you want to do work from home kind of requirements. Then we will see what are the risks associated and we should be aware about. What are the challenges in the overcoming or mitigating those risks? And we will also see what could be the solutions available for that. As you all know, Blackbox is one of the leading work from home solutions provider. So please do not think that this is going to be a Blackbox demonstration. We are going to take this particular webinar purely on imparting the knowledge. So we are going to take this particular entire presentation with a broader perspective. It is not going to be a product presentation. It is going to be a broader perspective. And I hope that it will add a lot of value and you will have good takeaways when we finish this particular webinar. So when we talk about risks, challenges, and solutions, we are all in the middle of this pandemic, not only in the pandemic time, but also before the pandemic times, as organizations work globally. You know, talent is not restricted to specific geography. So nowadays, people have recruited talents from remote locations, and they are supposed to work from remote locations. In pandemic, the entire concept of office work changed. And in order to continue the business continuity, organizations had to extend their office environment, extend their office software and operation management tools to the users at home. And that probably made this very popular thing as work from home. And yes, we call it WFH. Now let us start the agenda of this particular webinar. So before we understand nitty-gritties of work from home, risks, challenges, and solutions, let us just dissect this entire work from home. So I'm going to take this entire thing in a very layman language, okay? So I understand that there are people who have joined, they are either enterprise owners or they're seasoned IT professionals who know IT very well, as well as there are enterprise owners who don't know IT very well, but they know their requirements very well. They know the risks very well related to work from home. So we are going to balance between technology and lucid way of explaining the technology. So this is something which I want to simplify. When we talk about work from home, basically there are four things involved in this. You know, first is the applications and data which is residing in your office. It could be your tele application, it could be your ERP application, it could be your some homegrown application. It could be your file data, it could be your Word documents, scan documents, spreadsheets, designs, drawings, AutoCAD files, 3D Studio files, SolidWorks files. So a lot of data is there, which is normally in a MSME perspective, it is normally put inside the office servers or office storage devices. So that particular data lying inside the office, few of the enterprises have placed all these servers and NAS devices in the data center or in the cloud. But most of the people we are talking about, they have applications and data which are lying inside their office on their own storage hardware. So this is the one, this is the first part of what dissection we are doing for entire work from home process. So first thing is application and data, which needs to be shared. Now, these applications and data, how will it be shared? Then it will be shared by the internet bandwidth on the enterprise side. So any enterprise which has internet connectivity, it could be a broadband connection, it could be a lease line connection, whatever it is, that is going to be the enterprise side of ISP connectivity. When we are trying to provide for work from home thing, these applications and these data are going to be connect to the external world through this particular internal bandwidth, and it is going to be available to the external world through this internet bandwidth. Another part or another counterpart is the bandwidth at the user's level. So user might be remotely located working from home. So he might have connectivity like some mobile phone 4G connection hotspot, or maybe he might have a broadband connectivity. So this is how this user is going to reach to the enterprise network of his office. And then he is going to connect, and he is going to access those applications and data. So these are the four things. One is the computer of the remote user, which connects to the internet connectivity available to the user. That internet connectivity brings him to the enterprise level internet connectivity, which is normally a static IP. So static IP is just like an address, you know, where that particular request to access the data would land to the specific computer, to a specific router or specific office network. And after that, application data is rendered. So this is basically a very simplified explanation, technical explanation of work from home. And these are four things. So let me explain who are the stakeholders when we are talking about work from home, when we are trying to provide for work from home. Stakeholders are basically enterprise data owner or the custodian. You know, it could be the owner of the enterprise data, means the owner of the company, director of the company. If it is a medium size or large size company, there are custodians of the data, which are IT professionals. You know, these custodians of the data, IT professionals, are given mandate by the owners that our data should be safe, sound, and it should not be vulnerable to any hazard. And that is what we call them as a custodian. So one stakeholder, very strong stakeholder, very serious stakeholder, is enterprise data owner or custodian. Another stakeholder is the internet bandwidth provider to the enterprise. Third stakeholder is the internet bandwidth provider to the user. And the fourth stakeholder is work from home user himself or herself, who is using either his or his computer, personal computer, or company given computer. So these are the four stakeholders, and we will see different perspectives of these stakeholders on the work from home, and what are the components which are supposed to be used and which are supposed to be basically taken care of. So the first component is application servers, file servers, network attached storage device lying at the office of the enterprise. So that is the first component. Another component is there would be some software or tools to access the enterprise files, enterprise applications, enterprise emails. We will deal with this in detail. Third component is, of course, bandwidth, router, you know, router put by the router or firewall, which is put by the enterprise for protecting itself and for connecting itself on the internet. Fourth is the equipment on the user side. It could be broadband router or it could be mobile phone from which the hotspot is created. And the last component of this entire work from home design is either BYOD or bring your own device kind of user's personal computer, from which it is expected that enterprise's applications and data will be accessed and worked upon, or own company-owned computer, which is provided to the user, and user is told to use that particular computer for his own work related to the company. So these are the stakeholders and components of this particular process. Now, before we move to the next slide, I would like to just have a small poll among the audience or among the attendees. Please use this poll and let me know how many, what is the percentage are the custodians, what is the percentage are owners, what is the percentage are the remote work from home users. So I request Prasanna to launch the first poll. And I request all of you, we will take 1 minute, everyone can identify themselves, and then we can move forward. I will have a pretty good idea who are the kind of people who are attending this webinar, so that I can kind of make it more relevant. I see a few participants who are raising the hand. So I suggest that they can write down their questions in the Q&A part, and you know, we will take those questions at the end. So this is the result I would like to share for this poll. Thank you for taking this poll. 33% of the people are work from home users. 24% of the people are owners and custodians of the enterprise data. 43% of the people are professionals designing WFH solution. And I think we have majority of the people who are either providing the solutions related to work from home, or they are enterprise owners or custodians of the data themselves. So that's good to know. And this is the concern everyone is having. So we are now moving forward to our presentation. Meanwhile, I can just stop the share of the results. So now let us understand the risks, challenges, and solutions at every level of work from home. So when we talk about user's computer, you know, a user's computer is either user's own computer or provided by the company. The first concern is when user is working on company's data on that particular computer, which is lying outside of company's premise, lying in the house at the user's home. We need to provide for the backup of that particular computer, because user is spending his 8 hours, which he's supposed to spend on the at the company's office premise. You know, he's spending his 8 hours working for the company at home. So whatever data, digital assets he's generating on his computer, there has to be a solution. When we talk about work from home, we have to worry about the backup of those computers. If something happens to that particular computer, whatever work user has done will be lost, and it might make the enterprise lose business continuity. So in order to do that, normally we deploy cloud backup solutions. We install some Dropbox kind of client, or we install some Google Drive kind of client, or maybe we have some sophisticated expensive solutions in order to achieve this objective. But in that, there is a serious issue of data loss and leakage. That is a serious risk. I'll tell you why it is a serious risk. See, when you configure a Google Drive or kind of Dropbox kind of solution, and select the folders from the user's computer and set them for the backup on Drive or the Dropbox. There are three, four things. One, the user himself can change those settings, so it may not serve the purpose. Two, user might configure his own Dropbox account, and all the data backup happens on Dropbox account, and enterprise might be worried about that because that is not not taking care of data theft or data leakage kind of possibility from the users. And third is when we want to provide for the backup of the user's computer, and especially when user is using his own personal computer, he will have a lot of other data, his music, his videos, and sometimes that particular computer is being shared by so many family members. In that case, how we segregate that data, that this is our company's data, it should only be backed up and rest should not be backed up. So we are seriously concerned about the backup of that particular remote computer. The solutions which are available to us are some cloud backup solutions. The risks related are data loss and leakage, because that user might change the configuration, stop the backup, whatever he does, the admin of the company or the owner of the company does not know about it. And user can even configure some other Google Drive or Dropbox and take the data, and that might be related to information security related risk. So this is the first challenge or concern I would express. Another concern is remote access of the file application, remote access of the files applications. Like you have Tally, you have SAP, you have some homegrown software, you know, which user has to work on. Now, most of the times nowadays, I see that people use remote desktop, terminal server. They just take static IP, set up a terminal server, and then give remote desktop to everyone. Sometimes they use AnyDesk or TeamViewer kind of solutions. Or sometimes, you know, there are large companies who can afford, they take Citrix kind of solution. So there are risks, is RDP or AnyDesk or TeamViewer when these remote solutions are used. You know, the biggest risk is ransomware, and that has happened multiple times in the past, and it should not be done. If user is using, if the enterprise has provided for Citrix, then it is very expensive solution, but yes, it can take care of this very well. Many a times when we have such RDP or AnyDesk or TeamViewer, another challenge is it requires all the computers to be turned on at the office, and work from home purpose is not served because somebody has to be at the office to take care of those computers. Many a times we do not have any control, like we give application access to the user, but then user might export the data and then take it away, and there is a problem, there can be a problem for information security. So these are the challenges. Then a third challenge could be remote access to files and email data. So we have to provide the remote access of our designs, drawings, cost sheets, documents to the user, to the remote user. And again, when we do that through this kind of remote applications, we are exposed to the risk of ransomware, data loss, data theft. We are having the same challenges. We do not have any control what user does with those files and emails. He might just upload it to his personal things and all that. So information security. Fourth concern is when user is using computer at home, you know, he's out of our enterprise network. He's out of our domain. He's not using our firewalls internet. He's having his own internet connectivity. There, user might take the data away. User might take the data away, or he might steal the data over internet or USB port or email attachment. And a fifth thing is that many a times you require a lot of restrictions on the user's computer, because when user is working for the enterprise, whatever he does becomes enterprise liability. I will give you a short example. We came across one entrepreneur who shared with us that one of the users just installed one pirated software on the computer given by the company, and that pirated software was reported to the principal owner of the software company, which is Adobe or Autodesk, not Adobe, Autodesk. And they actually raided and they claimed on a very, very huge penalty and piracy allegations. So many a times we have to restrict the user what he can do and what he cannot do on the computers. So these are the concerns, and most of the times the risks are either related to ransomware or data loss or data theft. And challenges are we cannot control what user can do. We cannot control where user is giving the backup of his data. We cannot control when he stops backing up the data or he changes the destination of the backup. All these things are the concerns. So before I move to the next slide, I request Prasanna to launch a poll so we understand what are your biggest concerns, so we can take this particular session further in that particular direction. So these are all concerns, risks, challenges. You can tell us what are your concerns. So we are out with the results. Basically, the concern is we had listed all the concerns. So I think 9% of the people believe that data backup is the concern. 20% of the people believe that data leakage is a concern. 5% of the people understand that internet bandwidth utilization is a problem. And all of the above means all the concerns related to data theft, leakage, loss, everything, I think 66%. So whatever concerns we have listed, I think the poll suggests that majority of the people fully or partially agree to these concerns. So now we will move to the next part of the presentation. And before that, let me share the results. So I hope you are going through the results. Okay, so now let us move to the next part of the presentation. So let us understand this in a different way. See, it is very easy to tell about the problems, risks, challenges. It is also easy to find out problems in the solution. It is very easy to find out the negative points of the available solutions. So we thought that let us design something which helps everyone. So my next slide is about ideal WFH configuration for an enterprise. So what we are going to do is we have created, we have created two ideal WFH configurations, you know, and we have deployed them on two work from home computers, at Synersoft. And we are going to demonstrate that how this kind of work from home configuration can help, and it can achieve all the objectives, it can mitigate all the risks, and it can nullify all the challenges. So before we start, we already have that connection, and my team is already has already joined with me. Before we start, let me explain something on internet bandwidth, you know, because 5% of the people are saying that internet bandwidth is a problem. So let me tell you, when your people are working from home, you know, organization also saves a lot of cost. You know, it saves cost of hosting that particular user on the premise. And there are many other, many other benefits, when office is not operational. And in that case, what I always suggest, in case you want to have a very dependable work from home system, you should have very good internet connectivity. So at least one-to-one lease line connectivity and one backup broadband connectivity with static IP is highly recommended. On the user side, I don't recommend that you ask your users to connect through their Wi-Fi hotspot. See, every user is having his own personal life and they use internet in their personal for their personal purpose. And most of these mobile service providers give limited GB of the data every day. And nowadays, mobile is mostly used for WhatsApp and videos and all that. So that particular bandwidth is mostly utilized. And most of the times when users are working, they don't have that 4G connectivity. So instead of that, you should provide broadband connectivity to the users. It is not at all expensive. Hardly 400 rupees per month is the home broadband connectivity cost. And you can configure the broadband router of the user's home network such that he can use it only for the company purpose. So if you do that, whatever GBs are available on that work from home computer from that particular broadband user will not be used for the personal purpose, as well as you will have very good, reliable, dependable connectivity. And if you have good connectivity and if your users can work from home without any disruptions, their productivity will be more and enterprise will be at benefit. So this is something I wanted to tell about the internet bandwidth. Now we will start a demonstration of a ideal work from home profile. So first two things which we will see is device hardening and enterprise policy enforcement. So on the user's computer, it could be a user's personal computer or it could be user's company given computer. We will see how we can harden that device. Hardening that device means how we can make sure that user can do what is desired and user cannot do what is not desired. As well as we will see how user can access applications remotely without any security lapses, as well as how user can access the files without any security lapses. So temporarily I'm stopping my share and I request my technical team to connect to one work from home computer. I think we have a project manager computer which is for the work from home. So can we please connect and can you please share the screen for everyone's assistance? So now we are taking remote connection of this particular project manager profile. My colleague is connecting to that computer. The computer IP is 105 and he is connecting to it. It is Dell computer. He is going to connect now. So we are taking the remote connection to understand how hardening happens. So first of all, ideally you should remove administrative rights from the user's computer so that user cannot install any new software or anything. So if we see the control panel of this particular computer, if you see, all administrative privileges are already gone. User cannot have any kind of administrative privilege. Then another is you should allow only the applications which are supposed to be used by that particular user. So here we have allowed this user to use certain applications and we have allowed user not to use certain applications. Can we show the blocked applications? Let's say TeamViewer is installed on his computer, but we have not allowed him. So if he wants to use it, he cannot use it. Can we show some other application? AnyDesk, we have. So ideally you should have a system which lists the software installed on that particular computer and we can allow or disallow everything. So this is about the hardening part. Now we can see how this particular user can connect to the enterprise network. So we have installed Blackbox on this particular computer and we will see how his computer is hardened. So if we see his file browser, you will not see C drive, D drive, anything. You will see his professional drive. So in case he is using this computer from home, then in this particular profile, he will not be able to access his personal data, as well as he will not be, or any other family member will not be able to access this. So this is something which is available for the local. Now, let's say he wants to connect to the enterprise network and avail the files and folders and applications, then he has to connect to the VPN. Can we go to VPN? So in black box, we have connected. You can have VPN. I mean, it is not, you can do it from black box. You can do it from any other VPN technology. But yes, we have VPN technology also inside black box. So we are using it. So now this particular VPN connection will happen. It will be connected. As soon as we connect, it should give you the folders and files of your office network. You know, this user is on broadband connection, this user. So this VPN is being connected right now. And as soon as the VPN is connected, all the files and folders will be accessible from the office network. See, now this VPN is connected. So all the files and folders are accessible to this particular user from the office network, like software, projects, design, common folder, which they might be sharing, project manager and whatnot. So this is how one can access the files and folders. Now, let us see whether we are actually in the local area network or not. I request my colleague to ping the local server of the application. So now if you see, this is a local IP address 192.168, which is pinged, and we are inside the VPN now. And so we can access any applications which are available on, you know, in that office network, like Tally or SAP or whatever. And this is how we can have a very good secured access. Can you please close this window? All secured access to our folders, to our applications, without compromising on the security. Now, let me tell you something else. For example, some user who is working on the enterprise folders, and let's say he deletes all the data. Can you just quickly delete some data quickly? Let's say he does shift delete, he permanently deletes it. You can skip some files. So now it is deleted. Now for an enterprise, it will be very important to know who has deleted, and it will be very important to recover that data. So you can immediately recover this data. I would request my colleague to show us quickly how this data can be recovered. Now this data is deleted, but we can recover it, though this user is working from home. This kind of facilities are available in many solutions. Black box is one of that, which you can use it also. So now if we go to there, there will be a recycle bin on the enterprise network, and that recycle bin is not accessible to the user, and you can use that particular recycle bin to load the data. Yeah, is there any problem, Rajendra?
No.
So we can connect to this recycle bin anytime. We can restore the data, as well as we can know who has deleted the data. So this is remotely loaded. So I think it took a long time. Now we can go to the recycle bin. I think, Rajendra, if it is taking longer time for the recycle bin, we can move to some other point, and you can tell us when this recycle bin is loaded. Is it loaded? So you can actually identify the data from the recycle bin. We know that it was deleted from the common folder. We can identify, we can select that, and we can put it back to the common folder. Just do it quickly, Rajendra. It is more important to show the feature than, you know, doing everything with all data. So now we have done that. Now we will want to identify who has deleted the data. Of course, we can restore it so we can maintain the business continuity, but we would be interested that if there are 10 people working from home, we would like to know who has done that and did not inform. So we can go to this particular thing and we can just find out who has deleted the data. So you can also find out by the file name. So here it will tell us that project manager had deleted so many files. So this is how, this is a good formidable system. Rajendra, quickly close this, go back to project manager. Yeah, now I am sharing my screen for the next slide. Before we go to the next slide, I request Prasanna to launch the poll. We would like to know whether device hardening is important for you or not, and how you think that remote locations are. We'll just have a poll. So we are ending the poll. 75% of the people believe that it is difficult to make files and folders and ERP available with utmost security. 25% of the people say that it is okay, it is not that big deal. So I think majority of the people believe that it is going to be a big concern, and I think we have shown you what should be the ideal configuration. So now we will move to the next slide. Are you able to see my slide? Yeah, are you able to see my slide?
No, sir, it's on the same slide. Idle WHF configuration live demonstration.
Okay, just a moment. Why is it happening slow? Yeah, then it is about prevention of data theft over USB, email, and internet. And about monitoring, now it is also a very big challenge to monitor users while they are working from home. Sometimes we feel that they are not able to work from home properly as efficiently as they were working in the office. So we will now see, Rajendra, can we go to the project engineer's computer where we have done some special settings for USB, email, and internet. So let me tell you the purpose of this entire demonstration. What we want to show actually is basically from that work from home computer, user can take or leak or steal the data on USB port or on USB port or on email attachment or blind carbon copy or on internet basically. So now we will go to this project engineer profile. We were in project manager profile, which was slightly senior profile. So we have allowed pen drive in that particular account. here what we have done is we have not allowed pen drive in this particular account, but he is allowed to take inverting of the data from the pen drive. So this project engineer requires data from customer, which is sent to him by his own customers over pen drive, and he has to invert the data. Rajendra, can you just insert the pen drive on this, please? So now we are inserting the pen drive on this project engineer's computer. So it should be now visible. And once that pen drive is visible, we will try to copy data. Now this pen drive is visible. Just go to the pen drive. I mean, you have to connect to VPN, right? Let's say we want to give access to the data from VPN also. So now we'll connect to the VPN, so all enterprise data will be available to that particular user. So what we are going to do is we will connect to the VPN, we'll load the enterprise drives, and then we will try to copy the data from the pen drive to enterprise drive, and we will try to copy the data from enterprise drive to the pen drive. So we will understand what happens. So here this profile is configured to do it one way. So he can copy the data from the pen drive, but he cannot copy the data to the pen drive. So this is one special profile which we have designed. So in case you have people working from home who get data on pen drive, maybe from your printers, fabricators, vendors, whoever, they can actually you can use this kind of feature also. Yeah, Rajendra, if there is any connectivity challenge, we can skip this feature and we can move to other feature. You please advise.
I will inform you once connected.
Okay, so let us go to project manager's profile in that time period. Or by the time you know this profile is loaded, why don't you show the email part of this profile, project engineer's profile? We want to show that other thing is also right. So here this profile is having emails, so we are also worried about the email data theft. So here this profile is configured such that he can send an email, but it will go to the client or whoever he has sent that email only if his project manager is approving it. So you can have all these configurations. You can have configuration that this user can send email to only local people, or they can send email only to specific party, or they can send email but it has to be approved and then only it can go out, or he cannot send certain attachments, or he can send certain attachments but he cannot send specific size of the attachment. So all these things can be possible. So this is what we wanted to show. Rajendra, can we go to the project manager's profile in case that pen drive, in case that VPN is connected from project engineer's computer? You can show us, or you can go to project manager profile. You can go to project manager profile if project engineer VPN is taking more time. Rajendra? So where are we? We are on project manager or project engineer?
We are in project manager.
Right. So now we have seen, of course, we have not seen the pen drive part, but we would see in very shortly. Now we have got one project profile where this guy can copy the data. Now this pen drive is loaded on the project manager now. They have connected this pen drive to project manager. Now this project manager is copying the file. He is given the rights that he can take the files on pen drive. He will copy it and then he will paste it. So as soon as he does that, one report will be generated and it will go to his supervisor. Here in this case, it is director. So that report will go immediately that he has copied this file. So one, you will not allow pen drives. You will allow keyboard mouse. Two, you will allow pen drive, but only inward data. And you will allow pen drive for outward data, but the report will go to the project manager. So this is about the USP part. In email, as I have mentioned, you can have many many policies, and you should have such policies. Now we will see in this project manager's browser what internet he can check. Actually, right now he's connected to VPN, he has access to all the data, and now we can see what are his internet privileges, because we are also worried about data theft by the data theft over the internet part. So here, can you go to HDFC website? I think we have allowed project manager HDFC, right? Can you go to drive.google.com or Dropbox? We have not given this access to him because we are worried that our codes and everything can be taken away. It can be taken away. So we want to protect it. So we have not allowed project manager to, you know, have these websites. Now, what happens if this particular user requires to access the data, some website, you know, let's say customer has called him that I have uploaded some documents, you please download it from Google Drive. Or what happens if vendor has sent some data on Google Drive? What will he do? He cannot go to the system admin every now and then and say, please allow me. And he's in work from home. Of course, he's working from his home's network, but again, all these restrictions are applying, even if he's out of our firewall network. Now, we have given a happy hours here, which is an ideal situation. Rajendra, can you go to happy hours immediately? So in case he has got such a requirement in which he goes to happy hours, he has got a requirement where he has to visit a website which is not allowed to him by the administrator. In that case, he will, you know, right click on the black box. He will right click on the black box icon and activate the happy hours. As soon as he activates the happy hours, you can see all his drives will be unmounted. It will be all unmounted. Only download drive would be there. And then if you see his internet access, he can access Dropbox, Google Drive, whatever he wants, he can. And he can only download the data. So while he's working from home, he can access any website for his research work or for his professional work. But at the same time, he cannot access the data while he has access to unrestricted internet. So now he can go to Google Drive, he can go to his personal email ID, everything. Everything can be possible, but he does not have data to upload. He can only download the data. So he can finish his work, maybe research or maybe customer driven, whatever. He can finish this work and then exit the happy hours. Can we exit the happy hours, Rajan? So now he exited the happy hours. And now if you see, all those drives would be mounted. He can connect to VPN. All those drives will be mounted. In happy hours, he cannot connect to the VPN. Yeah, you can please connect to the VPN. And you can show what is there in his internet connectivity. So his local drive is now mounted. You can show what is his internet connectivity, Rajendra. His drives are mounted already. So again, he can go to HDFC, but he cannot go to Dropbox. So this is an ideal setting where we can stop user to take away our data, or we can mitigate the risk of data theft by the user over internet, because we have no control on which internet that particular user is working on and accessing. So this is about internet part. Now the last part of my particular slide was about productivity monitoring. So we will see now the productivity monitoring, how you can monitor the productivity. So you should have some tool which actually monitors the activities of the user. Rajendra, can we please show them Playback Office? So here you can configure something. You know, there are so many tools you can explore. You can configure something where every 30 second or 1 minute user screen will be captured, and that will be uploaded on your server. And then you have some way of looking at it. In black box, it is done in very organized way. So now we will select project manager as a user, because we want to see what he was doing. And then let us do it today's session only, 4 to 5, or kind of. I think it all started only after 3:30, 3 to 4. It's all started 3 to 4. So 3 to 4, I think from 3:30 onwards, you will have those screens, because project manager was logged in. So if you see all these screens, you know, so we can actually investigate, and now you can save all these screens for as many days as you want. So this is about the productivity monitoring. Rajendra, any luck on that VPN connectivity from engineer's drive? We can show the pen drive or we can skip that?
Sure, sir.
Any luck?
Yes. I'm logging with project engineer.
Then let's show that, yeah. I think project engineer could not connect VPN. They're all, see, these all are working from home actually.
VPN is connected.
Yeah, so now the pen drive is loaded as well as all the VPN drives are loaded. So first, let us try to copy something from the pen drive to the local drive. Just do it for one file in the interest of time. Just do it. Copy, paste. So we are from pen drive, we are able to copy the file to the local drive. Now from local drive or a VPN drive, please try to copy the file to pen drive. He cannot do that. So it's an inward only kind of pen drive settings which we have done. So now, yeah, Rajendra, can you please give back the screen to me? So what we have understood is that it is very important for us to make sure that users can access the things without any difficulty. At the same time, organization does not compromise on its information security settings. I will request Prasanna to launch one poll just to consolidate on what we are believing and what is audience or audience opinion. I think we have put long questions. It takes time to read. So we are ending the poll. I'm sharing the poll results. 88% of the people believe that it is difficult and it exposes enterprise to risk of data loss because backing up of the remote computer is very important. 12% of the people say it is not a serious challenge. 85% of the people say that it is necessary to be able to monitor the productivity of the employees. And 100% of the people this time say that yes, users can leak the data or USB email and attachment and internet while working from home. It's a serious challenge. So I'm glad everybody is so sensitive to data leakage and theft. So now we will move to the next part of this particular presentation, which is the last part. So when I want to summarize, ideally your work from home profile should be hardened. You know, you should know which computer you should access your data from. You should know and define which applications should be accessible. That user should not be the administrator of his own system. And there should be, you know, VPN configured on that particular system, and files and applications should be accessed only over VPN. Application controls have to be there. Sometimes they install some pirated software or some TeamViewer kind of software and you have data leakage problem. Segregation of the data is important when you are not giving computer to the user and you are allowing users to work from their personal computer. That personal computer will have a lot of data which is not meant for you, and that personal computer would be shared by the family members. Again, you need to have a segregated profile for that. You should have good access control on VPN. You should know who can configure the VPN, who cannot configure the VPN. And whatever data you have allowed to reside on user's computer to work offline, it should be automatically backed up. You should have USB policy on your user's work from home computer. You should have email vigilance proper email vigilance if you are allowing user to work on email system. You should have isolation of data while user is on full internet access. You have to allow internet to be used as a resource. At the same time, you have to make sure that it is not misused as a hazard to leak your data. There has to be any communication happening to your enterprise network has to be from VPN. And you should have some tool by which you can monitor users' activity and you can find out who is productive, who is not productive. So this is basically about this particular presentation. And now I would invite the questions. I think we have already people who have posted their questions. So I will play a small short video which summarizes on this particular presentation. You enjoy that video. Meanwhile, we will understand your questions and we will answer this question in next 10 minutes. So I'm just playing that particular video for everyone's just a moment. I'm just sharing the screen. I hope you are able to see the video.
Still loading, sir. Thank you.
So this is about the video I wanted to share. Just a moment. So now we have a few questions. We have answered all the questions and they are visible to your screen. Will you share the presentation? We do not have a policy to share the presentation. Mr. Vijay Lohar asked, we want this kind of solution. Of course, you can contact us offline. Vikas Acharya, how black box system is different from Kaseya? See, Kaseya is basically a remote support tool. It is not a work from home tool. It will not, I mean, we will send you the comparison, but I think it will not benefit everybody who has, attended this webinar. So we'll send you a comparison for that. Mr. Netaji Chavan is asking that whether you require static IP and port forward. Yes, you require static IP on your office location. You don't require static IP at the user's location. At office location, static IP will be activated and that will be only available on the VPN port. There are certain VPN ports like 1723 on which the port forwarding happens, but that port forwarding has to happen only for the VPN connection. Many a times I have seen that people are forwarding the ports like 3389, which is remote desktop port, and it is kept open. Now then it's a cake, you know, for the hackers. You know, hackers can hack in and, you know, plant ransomware and, you know, screw your servers. So once you need to understand that port forwarding has to happen, but it has to happen only on VPN port. Dhaval Shah is asking, what happened if Google Sheets shared with users? How can we control? See, if you are concerned about the security, you should not use Google Sheet. You should not use any public cloud. You should use your private cloud. So private cloud means just like we had shown in the demonstration, where as soon as you connect to the VPN, all the folders, files, everything is available, and then users can collaborate. Then Ganesh Kumar is asking, additional system required? Except a black box. No, you don't need to have any other system other than black box. Everything whatever shown was completely included in black box features. Otherwise you can achieve the same features from other systems also, but then in that case you need to integrate so many different systems and install so many endpoint software. Kamlesh Sitapara, if someone using Google Apps, so how can we convert him to use black box, because mail storage is used almost 40 users? Yes, you can convert them easily, because black box is not it is not replacing Google email system. Google email system would be there only. Only thing is black box will create a layer between the Google and between the user, and whatever user does on Google emails, it will be subjected to the policy. So just like we had shown you one email client on the screen, you know, in project engineer or project manager's login, we are also using Google services, but we are not giving direct Google access, Google service access to the user. So there is always a provision. Yeah, Mr. Netaji Chauhan is saying we are using G Suite. Yeah, you can use G Suite, but for file sharing and file collaboration, you should not use Google Drive, because there is a big problem. When you allow your user to access your enterprise Google Drive, user can log out from that and user can then log in his personal drive, and then he can upload your data. So it is not a secured solution. You can use G Suite for its fantastic email capabilities and Google Meet capabilities. Otherwise, for file sharing and everything, you should use private cloud if security is the concern. Netaji Chavan is also asking, how can we access Gmail? Yes, you should not access Gmail. You should access Google through cloud, Google through the email client, or Blackbox has its own webmail client, which users can use on the browser. But if you give Gmail access to the user, he can sign out and he can log into personal login, and then all your data is open. Mr. Vijay Lohar is saying we also need RDC license. No, in black box virtualization application, you do not need RDC license. Black box is having its own application virtualization software. Kamlesh Sitapara, also they are using RDP server. all local data is on RDB server with Active Directory. Correct. So this is good. But when you are working from home, every user when they are connecting to RDB server over static IP, it has a lot of risk. Basically, you should avoid that particular risk. So any further questions? We would like to. I think I've answered all these questions live. Kamlesh Chakra, now Karan. Karan is asking, what if there is no directory service? You don't need directory services if you have Blackbox. Blackbox has its own domain controller and directory services. You don't need any directory services. Entire environment which we had demonstrated is on a workgroup environment. It is not driven by any directory services. If hardware fail, what time taking about restore? You can take twin hardware. So if one fails, another is available on high availability. And of course, if you have only one hardware and if how much time it takes, then it should take 3 to 5 hours to restore the data. So if that window you can afford, you should take one hardware. If you cannot afford that particular window, you should take two hardware. Kiran Shetty is asking, do we need CAL license? No, you don't need CAL license when you use Blackbox. You don't need RDP CAL also. Siraj Khan is asking, just a moment. He's asking, do we need to use Thunderbird? Thunderbird only. No. You can use any email client. There is no problem. You can use any email client. So I think we have no more question. I have answered all the questions. So we are overshooting the time by 8 minutes. If everyone agrees, we can wait for 5 more minutes and I can take up more questions. At home, do we need to separate ISP while work from home? You don't need to. I just told that you should have a separate ISP for your work from home so that you can do your job well. If you are sharing the connection, then most of the times at home we use internet for a lot of things. We use internet for Amazon Prime, OTT platforms, video. Our kids use our home network for their online classes. So maybe a lot of bandwidth is utilized. So if your company is providing you allowance for ISP, you can take a different, a separate ISP, it will help. Then can you share company brochure and PDF format? I think Prasanna, can you please take it up, all such requests? We will definitely give all those details. You can also read our websites, a lot of videos are there, but there's a lot of videos are there. So I think from Siraj Khan, can we connect our internal NAS to Blackbox to map user drives? Yes, you can do that, but you need Blackbox. Blackbox serves as a NAS device also. So actually your NAS device would be redundant if you use your NAS device as well as Blackbox. So you can use NAS device as a backup device for your Blackbox. Blackbox is inbuilt NAS device also. It has a storage device also. Yeah, then we have one more question. How is Blackbox system different from Kasaya? Can you share this presentation video? We will think about it and discuss it internally because this webinar is going to be a series. Every month this kind of webinar is going to happen. So we would not like to circulate this content. We want people to hear this content live and ask the questions. If Blackbox device is crashed, so that at what time, what can we do? Yeah, you can restore the data. As I explained, Blackbox has an endpoint and every Blackbox has a backup on the data center. I will just show you on the screen. 1 minute. Just a moment. So see, every black box device along with its systems, you know, you just see my screen, you will see all the black boxes available. You are able to see my screen? So I've just logged on to this backup data center backup system. I will just log in again. I hope my screen is visible. Prasanna, can you confirm?
Yes, sir, it's visible, sir.
So if you see this, all the black boxes can be backed up on the data center or cloud, whatever you have. We also have our own data center, and you can restore the data whenever you want it. So just a moment. So you can see that whatever work from home computers are loaded with black box client, you know, all those backup report you can see here, and certain black box device backup report also you can see on the screen. And then you can see the report, and in case you want to restore the data, you can restore the data. You can also identify the error. So these are all possible. So if black box device crashes, you can very well restore the data. You have also an option to have two black box devices which are on high availability, and you can work on it. So either of that, whatever you want. Then something is there. One moment, let me check. It is better if you ask the question in the question answer, because people are asking questions in the chat also. Normal Gmail ID can be used. We have free Google. Yes, you can use normal Gmail ID, and Blackbox can vigil it. Then there are four more questions. I think we will take two more minutes to answer these questions. If Blackbox device is crashed, I have answered this question. Siraj Khan, can we restrict URLs in happy hour session? Yes, you can. You can do that. Yes. In happy hours also, you can restrict the URL. Amlan is asking if a customer has other applications which require RDP access via VPN. Yes, you can do that. Blackbox VPN itself is a good protection. Instead of just giving RDP access in a very naked way, don't do that. Use Blackbox VPN. Once the user is in VPN in local area network, then give RDP connection. So that will definitely help and, you know, protect. Then Umesh is asking, is there antivirus option in Blackbox? No, you have to install the antivirus on your own. Can we connect one Mac and one phone to the same Blackbox? Blackbox does not support the Mac OS. It supports iOS. So, you know, you can connect either Android or iOS, but then you can also have the same sort of restrictions on your iOS device or Android device. We do not support Mac. Where the screen record will be stored? It will be stored on the Blackbox hardware. Blackbox hardware has ample of storage, so it will be stored over there. When we restore Blackbox from data center, at that time, can we restore policy as well? Yes, policy, folder permission, everything can be restored. Everything can be restored. How many VPN connection possible in one Blackbox? See, every Blackbox hardware comes with number of users, 12 user, 20 user, 40 user, 70 user, 90 user. So number of licenses for which that hardware is enabled, you can access those number of people over VPN. So I think in case you have any questions, you can forward your questions to prasanna.dv@signersoft.in. Prasanna, you please share your email ID to everyone on the chat. And I thank you everyone for this overwhelming, I think we have one more question. No, question is done. So overwhelming response to this webinar. And I hope it was a good session. You had good takeaway. And in case you have any comments, feedback, after we end this seminar, you will be given a survey link. Please give us your feedback. So next time when we come up with some other topic, we can do it better. Thank you very much. Thank you so much.